Peace, people. Your boy, the most fabulous T-Bear183 here. And, I guess I'll just call this the anatomy of a mix, or at least a T-Bear mix. A little bit of behind the scenes. Trying to go through some stuff. I'm working on the October mini mix for GRYSKLL. And, putting some stuff together. So, what I got, this is pretty much the set list of some stuff that I worked out. This sound pretty decent and what have you. What I'm getting ready to go through now, because I got some of this stuff, I got some of it digital, some of it is on wax. And I may write down the speeds, or I may at least write down the BPM. Because, see, I threw it in a playlist. I'm kind of new to this Serato game. I'm a Traktor person. Serato is nice. There are some differences, and I think I'm going to start making videos of differences between Traktor and Serato. Some ish I don't really like, but we're gonna work with it anyway. So I dropped the joints that I'm gonna do in a playlist, or a crate as they call it. All of them ain't in there, mostly because, like I said, some of them are on wax. This is my I'm working out of crate. So a lot of times y'all see me doing mixes and stuff, you'll see me pull from this crate and not from the shelf. That's because this is what I'm working out of crate. So I throw the stuff in here. It's a quick grab. I don't have to flip through all of this mess. Well, it's not mess. For the most part, they're in alphabetical order. You know, all of this is hip hop to down there, I think. Then this is house music, which I need more house music on wax. This is R&B soul, from there to there, down to there. Then I got other stuff, comedy, jazz, got some gospel albums, and the rest of these shelves just kind of hold crap for now. Some CDs down there. My 45s is on the other side of the room. But anyway, I didn't went off on a tangent already. That's how I do. Anyway, so I'm gonna start going through these stuff, and I'm gonna write down some of the speeds and whatnot, and just kind of go through and deciding should I do that with you guys or not, you know, or just let you see how it go. But anyway, I guess I didn't start with how I put together a mix. Maybe I should turn around so y'all can see me talking here. So basically what I do, I may think about some stuff and it'll be a song that I gotta use. So I'm trying to think of which song I started with this one. I know exactly what I started with. So with this one, I wanted to use wax paper from J Live. Why? I don't know. I just been wanting to use it for a while. I had it. I got it on digital from a CD, a rip, and then I just got the wax in maybe a month ago. He posted he had some more of these, the best part, and he even signed it, so that was dope. You see the piece, Marcus, you know, y'all know my name, my real name is Marcus, that ain't no secret, but whatever. So I was like, man, I'm finna use this. So I'll probably use the digital copy because it'd be easier for what I gotta do, but I do have it on wax, so So it's like, but if you look through the set list that I put on there, that's not the first song. So what usually happens is that song will be in my head, and then I'll start finding stuff to go with it. Sometimes things go in front of it. A lot of times things go behind it. I don't really know how. What's the choice? What's the decision? It's basically just going through stuff, trying to see what'll fit, and also trying to use it that I haven't used in a while or haven't used before. I try to do that too. So if you're going through my mixes, you don't get a lot of redundant songs. I would like for people to be able to play my stuff from, I can't say start to finish, mix to mix, maybe. Like if you just go through my mix cloud and do a play all, if that's even an option. I don't want you to continuously keep hearing the same damn songs. That's a pain in the ass. So anyway, not a pain in the ass. It's just, I don't want to do that. I want everything to be pretty much different. So I'm gonna go through some of this stuff, write these speeds down, and then we go from there. Alright, so that Strictly Butters joint, what I want to use in the beginning, I got it on 45. I don't want to use the 45. I'll run it on through Serato, but it runs at 85 BPMs. Some of the other stuff I got tops out at 95. So without doing a bunch of speed adjustments, I think I'll try to compromise, meet in the middle. Maybe run this mix at like 93 BPM. That way everything in there can be adjusted to that. So let's see what we sound like here. Speed it up. Oh, that sucks. Maxing this table out, at least pushing it to 10, that give me almost 93. It give me to like 92 and some change. So I can probably bump everything up to 93, but I think I'll just leave it there. So what I'll do, I'll just write down the speed. Now I figure out how I'm gonna bring in the rest of the stuff and where I'm gonna bring it in at. So this is sort of like the practice, and then I go back and record it. I don't always do this. A lot of times I just write down the set list. But like I said, since I'm kind of going back and forth, and then I know one or two of these songs is like really, really short, like minute and a half. So it's not a whole lot of fumbling time. So when I get those, that's why I write stuff down, so I can just glance at it real quick, get it cracking. But from this one, I'll go into this one, into what, some people under the stairs, I think. And this is dope, by the way. Let me, when you're messing around on this damn 72, I could pick my stuff. You see that? This is the same playlist that I got sitting up there. This is that crate. And that joint I'm looking for, Sweet for the Beaver. Click it, boom, it's there. And you know, once you see it's running at 90, we want to get it. See, that's what, 92.7? So it runs at 90. Already, all you know is you're going to come up. So that'll be 91. That should be 92. So somewhere around here, we should be able to find the sweet spot. Let's grab a joint. Serato control record. It's awkward doing this with one hand, you know. Anyway, just running it without. You got, what is that, 93, 92.8. So it might be a little fast. We'll play with it. I gotta remember how I'm bringing it in too. And adjust my damn volume too. I don't like stuff peaking. I like hitting that first yellow. And that's one of the things I want to get into when I talk about the differences, because this mixer do some stuff my other one does not do. Or wait a minute, I'm saying that wrong. My other mixer does some stuff that this one doesn't do that I like better on my old joint. But like I said, I'll get into that later on. Anyway, I'm going to start putting this stuff together. Check back in with y'all later on.
Suspect named me, a street legend. Pulling hits was his infatuation. From birth, his first spoken word.